Hey guys, how you all doing? It's me, KP Studios, aka KP, and I'm with my friend once more, George. Do you want to say hello?
Hi. Hi again.
Yeah, it's been a while, but we're back with episode 3 of our KP and GB podcast. I think episode 2, what I could see, it's been over a month now. I think it was like early September we last made one, so it has been a while.
Yeah,
But
yeah.
but we're back, and we've got a
We're
lot of things
back,
to talk
baby.
about. Oh wow, I just realized something actually. I had 3.8 subscribers. I've gone down to 3.79. No! I mean, anyway, I've lost a subscriber down, but oh well, we move on. We'll carry on with this podcast. I don't know why I just said that. I just realized on my channel. I was like, wait, what? I've lost a subscriber. No!
Oh well.
But yeah, anyway, in this podcast, we'll probably be talking about, we went Sonic Symphony 2 weeks ago. So we'll be talking about that. We'll talk about some other stuff as well, like obviously, Sonic X Shadow Generations coming out at the end of this month. Really looking forward to that. And also the prequel animation as well, Shadow Dark Beginning. So we'll definitely talk about that as well. But first of all, we'll talk about Sonic Symphony. So yeah, me and George went to it 2 weeks ago. I was about to say 2 years ago. Not 2 years ago, God. 2 weeks ago, and it was in Apollo, Hammersmith, London, right?
Yeah, it
Apollo,
was
wasn't
at
it?
the Apollo in Hammersmith. Yeah, was where the latest Sonic Symphony concert took place, or at least in the UK. For the record, I was lucky to go to the one when it was at the Barbican last year. You unfortunately couldn't join me, so for that, but.
I remember that. Yeah, because it just I think I was on holiday that week, wasn't it? And it just clashed with it. I didn't realize that until I told you. But
Yeah.
that kind of sucked that I missed that. But obviously I'm glad I managed to go to this one, and I'm glad I did. Because obviously, I think we met up with one of your friends there as well, and he even said to me that, "Oh yeah, you're gonna love this. It's gonna be brilliant." Because obviously, he went last year as well, like you, and he wasn't wrong. It was absolutely brilliant. Like I wouldn't say exceed my expectations. I did expect it to be cool, but yeah, because I know at the start they had an orchestra, didn't they? For a bit, and I like that they had a, was it Ocean Palace or Seaside Hill? Had one of them Sonic. I think it was Ocean Palace, wasn't it? I think the
Yeah,
orchestra
we
version
may
of
be
it.
going a bit ahead, but I guess that maybe don't need to explain. I guess if people watch this, probably may have an idea or something. But the Sonic Symphony basically is a live, a live concert. First half, like you said, first half or first act, if you call it, is the orchestra playing renditions of various like Sonic music, like from Sonic 1, like to like you said, Sonic Heroes, which was new for the surf this for this particular performance. And they had like videos of gameplay, good throughout the games, just to accompany the music. But the second half or second act is basically a rock concert, pretty much. Doing all of like the vocal themes, from stuff like the adventure games, and not surprising with Shadow Generations and it being the year of Shadow.
Year of Shadow, Year of Shadow, baby.
Yeah, they had to quite. They started pretty promptly with like various Shadow themes. All Hell
Like I Am All
Shadow, I Am
Me.
All of Me, and Never Turn Back, like the it was the ending theme for Shadow, wasn't it? The game.
It was, yeah. Oh yeah, I forget. You haven't played the game, have you? Oh, we've got to get you on that.
Yeah, well, I know the music. I know sort of enough of sort of that really, but no, there was that and like various themes like Live and Learn, Endless Possibility, and
This world as
His
well.
World. Yeah, His World was there.
This world,
And I
sorry.
think
His
another
world, yeah.
London exclusive was they had like a Sonic R medley where they actually got Richard Jacques and TJ Davis, I think is the name of the singer. Who sang a Can You Feel the Sunshine, Supersonic Racing, the classics, which was really cool.
Yeah, it was a nice surprise that was, yeah.
Yeah.
But yeah, it was really good. Like, I remember we were just singing our guts out. We were just screaming, sorry, not guts, singing our lungs out.
Yeah, I think the best thing about these from having been to the both Sonic Symphonies, it's just been the atmosphere, because you're going in with like passionate Sonic fans, who've played the games, just love the franchise, the music, sort of everything. The atmosphere is electric. It's just everyone's
Yeah,
singing,
so
everyone.
many.
And this year they I think they had like glow sticks you could buy, we didn't get any because just because the queues, well, the queue to get in was already quite a bit. Was quite a bit. You know, that may be one of the flaws.
Oh yeah.
Just, I don't think they were. I don't think the venue was prepared just for how you know how many fans were going to turn up or something. So you know, we were out for like an hour before then just to open. That was before the doors could open. You know, thankfully when we got in, it was fine getting the seats or whatever. Though you know, people getting merch and everything was you know.
That was a struggle,
which I don't think was worth. I don't think was worth it, you know. But you know, you could buy some glow sticks, and they would match, you know, sort of with the performance and everything. And you know, it's just amazing to see all those colours and you know, people waving them. And again, pretty much second half is just a rock concert, and it literally has the vibes of that, really. Which you know.
Yeah, it was really good. Yeah, but going back to the merchandise, yeah, like even if you fail to get the specific merchandise you wanted from the event, it will not need to worry about it. You can always, like, well, guys, you guys know anyway, you can always get it online anyway.
Yeah, there's the online store, which I do remember the first from the one last year. They had a store, but they had two performances last year just because it was just that popular. I went to the evening one, but by the time I got to the evening one or before the evening one, they had sold out completely, which was why they made the online store after that to sort of to accommodate that. And I think, you know, they gave people who didn't get the merch, they got like a early access and a code. In fact, that's how I got my the shirt I wore, the Symphony shirt I got from that was what I wore for the This Is performance. So you know, so no, it's good they have that at the very least. I don't know if they'll sell the glow sticks or not, but they'll definitely sell like the shirts and the, you know, the clothing and posters and such. So you know,
yeah, but like you said, yeah, a lot of people turned up. Like everyone, I think we expected it because, you know, Sonic franchise, Sonic fans, there's so many, you know, Sonic's so big all over the world.
Yeah, and I think the UK may be one of some of the most passionate, I think, you know, just I know that Sega consoles, you know, were big back in the day. You know, I think they were bigger than Nintendo, really, which I know is crazy to think, especially nowadays, but you know, so but you know, a lot of people just probably have a lot of nostalgia. Then, I mean, again, I could tell from our family, you know, from we were limited, but still, you know, I think I've said before from a previous episode, you know, my early experiences and such. But you know, you know, doesn't surprise me. You know, just especially, you know, now more than ever with the, you know, the films and the, you know, shows and just, you know, Sonic's bigger than ever, really. So you know, it's still cool going to these events and just sort of seeing how dedicated, you know, the fans are. We saw some really cool, you know, cosplays and such. I think I remember someone dressed as Robotnik from the movies, which I thought was cool. Someone was just as Jet the Hawk, which I know you were a fan of.
Oh yeah, Jet the Hawk. I didn't expect that. What the hell?
Yeah.
Yeah. But yeah, that was cool, yeah. But you know, if you guys are watching, if you went to that event, let us know in the comments below, and also, you know, let us know what you thought as well. Like, share your experience of it. Like, I'd be interested to know what you think. And also, we did record a few footage of it on our phones. So what I'll do is, at the end of this video, I'll try and hopefully at the end of this video you'll be able to see the footage. I'll try and get the videos imported from my phone onto my PC, and I'll timestamp in the description below. So if you want to, like, if you want to listen to all of us. To us rambling, and you want to see the thing, or you want to come back to this, feel free to just skip forward on the description timestamp where it's timestamped where it is. And yeah, you could probably hear me singing really badly, but I think the music and other people singing goes over it, so you hopefully don't hear me. But you know, if you do, just have some ear pods on because you don't want to hurt your ears. But yeah, you don't hear any screeching. No,
yeah, it's part of the atmosphere, but, you know. If going to a Sonic concert, you know, you're not gonna sing along or at least sort of vibe with it. It's like, what are you doing?
Yeah. Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. But yeah. Let us know. You know, if you guys went, I'll be cool to know. But I do know. What was it, George? I know they do it in America as well. I'm pretty sure they do it. Do they do it anywhere else? It's just America and England.
It's more than. I mean, yeah. That's the one thing that that's disappointing about being in the UK is that I believe it's only been in London. It definitely was from, you know, the performance that I've been to. I don't think there's anywhere else in the UK, but you know, they definitely have quite a lot more in America. I don't know if by the time this will be, or maybe by now, I think there was going to be one that was going to be in Florida, funnily enough.
Yeah, they're doing like doing a world tour, aren't they?
Yeah, it's a whole world tour, I think, as they're calling it. I think, you know, there were some in Europe and like Paris. I think Japan definitely does. You'd think it'd be in Japan, given where Sega's based
Yes,
and
there's gonna be
everything.
some in. I'm just looking now. There's gonna be one in Chicago, Orlando, Hausen, Nashville, Philadelphia, Dallas, and quite a
I think
few. But yeah,
New
that's cool
York, I
though.
think, had theirs before us, before for this
Yeah.
year's rotation again, because
Yeah, in June.
it's officially in its second year, I guess. But yeah,
It will be cool
if
to do it outside
you're
though.
more likely if you're outside of the UK and haven't been, well, maybe you'll get a chance. And if you haven't, well, we'd highly recommend it, certainly. If you are a Sonic
Yeah,
fan, and
definitely.
yeah, it's
You'll
amazing,
love it.
definitely. Go book it, though. Try to book ahead of time, because these things go fast. So try to.
Because how long in advance did we book it? I can't remember now.
I forget exactly. It was at least a few months. It was pretty lucky
Yeah,
this
yeah.
time, honestly, because I know last year's one was like lasted within like minutes. But I think this one was a bit. Mind you, they had a pre-sale or something. I think they made sure to give people enough notice this time. So so this wasn't as bad, but still, try
Yeah,
to
maybe they learned from last time, yeah.
try to at least search Sonic Symphony, and I'm sure that you could sign up for a mailing list, and sort of just to help with when the next shows are in your area, or when tickets go live and such. Just to make that easier. But still, it's highly recommended.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, like George was saying, if you guys are big Sonic fans like us, you don't want to miss out on this. You'll love it. Like I loved it. It was absolutely brilliant. I wish I went to the other one as well, but oh well. At least I went to one. I can say that at
No,
least.
I mean, in some ways,
Yeah.
it's probably good you went to this one, considering, like I said, Year of Shadow, more of the Shadow focus, and you had Sonic Heroes and such.
Yeah, my favorite character, Year of
I
Shadow.
was almost gonna
Yeah.
like ask, did you have a favorite from the show, like favorite song,
Oh, do I have a favorite?
or favorites? Because there's too much to choose from, really.
Yeah, you couldn't go wrong with Live and Learn. That was really good at the end. Like they always do it at the end. They got it at the end. That's one of the iconic Sonic like songs from SA2. What else? I liked the Knuckles raps. They were funny as well. Unknown
Oh
Fruit,
yeah,
and
I was surprised they actually threw in the Knuckles ones as well, because which again makes sense. We did have the Knuckles show and 30th anniversary of Sonic
yeah.
3 as well, so
Your favorite show, the Knuckles show, you loved it, innit? It's so good.
we'll save that for another episode.
Yeah, and obviously the Shadow ones, because obviously, come on, Shadow for a character, All Hail Shadow, I Am All Me, that was just vibes, it was so good. Obviously there was Sonic Frontier stuff as well. I didn't say I didn't like him, because I only completed the game recently with you actually. I didn't find him that iconic to me. Like, they were sounding pretty cool. Some guys really liked it. There was one guy in front of us. He kept just waving. He had afro. He kept shaking his head over and over. I'm like, all right, whoa, all right.
Yeah, again, full on
But
the full on rock concert. Like, that's they
yeah,
went really, for better or for
yeah.
worse, depending if you
I
like
mean,
them or not, but they went really hard, like the music in Frontiers, especially like the boss themes. I think that everyone, I
yeah.
think they're the songs that everyone raves about, and makes sense why they brought them here.
Yeah, like yeah, I understand why my fans liked it and all that. I didn't mind it, but obviously, because I don't know it as much as the other games, and have much like per meaning for me, if that made sense. So, yeah, but yeah, I had a lot of favorites though. But what about you, George? Did you have any particular favorites that you liked or favorite?
Yeah, it's a tough. Mentioning earlier the Sonic R medley, I think was cool. Sort of given that the
That was
people,
cool, yeah.
the musicians were from the UK, so it's nice to have an exclusive thing. It was there last year, but Endless Possibility is like one of my favorite vocal themes, and I thought just
Oh
hearing that
yeah, we
live
forgot to mention
was
that.
just
Yeah, that was there as well.
that was it's always great hearing that. I mean, again, Live and Learn, it's just such a good it wasn't quite the end, but it was definitely like a good sort of way to.
Oh, it's one of the end ones, yeah,
Yeah,
sorry. Yeah, one of the end.
so no,
It's been a couple of
that was
weeks.
cool. I was just it wasn't there, but I did like the. I wish it was there this year, but I saw it last year. I was lucky I saw that sort of the previous year. But there was a really good Sonic CD medley, which was really cool, from last year's show. But in the orchestra section. But generally, I'd say yeah, all of the music was just of good, was just of high quality. I mean, you know, the
Yeah, it
Sonic
was.
music is just good in general, really. So it's no surprise it works really well with an orchestra and the band and just and everything, really. So no, it's just such a good show.
Yeah, no, it was really good, yeah. But yeah, I think we've spoken about that long enough then. Well, if you have anything else to add to it, George, about Sonic Symphony or
No, not
the
really. No, again, it's just such a good show. And again, if you haven't seen it and get the chance to, definitely go see it, really.
Absolutely. Yeah, definitely. Yeah. But anyway, so guys, as you know, fellow Sonic fans, Sonic X Shadow Generation, that's coming out in about couple weeks, 25th of no October, not November, bloody hell. I'm really hyped for that. What we've watched the Shadow Dark Beginnings, which is like a prequel animation, prequel, three small episodes in the prequel in the build up to the game. If you guys haven't seen it, then please check it out before you hear this, unless you want spoilers. If you want to skip ahead, just click on the next timestamp when we finish talking about it, and then yeah. But if you have seen it, then please stay here. I'll give you about 3, 2, 1, go. All right, we're gonna talk about it now. So spoilers. I thought it was really good. Like, the animation was absolutely brilliant. I know it was short, but George, I would have loved if they could make a series like that. I would love it so much. And I love the fact that Team Dark was in it as well. Omega was back. Rouge, that was really good. And the characters were so funny. They just like work so well together. Like, it was so funny when they're fighting a massive robot. Omega goes, "I call dibs," and stuff like that. And it was cool because you get a bit more insight to Shadow's past. Because we had Shadow the Hedgehog, which was almost 20 years ago. So I do find it cool that they're getting back to that. And you just find out basically Shadow, in a nutshell, Shadow's trying to infiltrate Eggman, one of Eggman's bases, to try and get a ship to go on to the Ark, I think. And also, Gun going past Gun as well. So I think it was basically, I think to stop Black Doom, because obviously they were saying the Black Khan's return or something, wasn't it? But it's been a while since I've seen the first one. But but I thought it was really good. What do you think, George? You want to talk about it on your end?
Yeah, I mean, again, we've had quite a few animations for the past Sonic games. I want to say since Sonic Mania, I think, or at least the re-release of Sonic Mania, they've just made an animation to tie between each of the games, really. And I think they've all been generally good, but I think the latest one, Dark Beginnings, may be the best one, I think, just because it's it's just it makes it not just it's good at just being a good a prologue for the game, obviously just to get people to be excited for the Shadow Generations, buy the game,
The build up
but
for it, isn't it?
it's they've really gone hard on just the history and just it still blows my mind, honestly, that we're at a point where they are kind of going back to not just Sonic Adventure 2, Shadow the Hedgehog, just sort of like going this deep in the lore of
Yeah, they reference how we beat the Black Arms, wasn't it? And also, we also saw the Gun Commander as well from the Shadow Hedgehog game. So he returns at the end of the third episode.
who
He's
has a full
basically.
name, which again, forgive me if I'm wrong, like maybe the first he's called Abraham Tower or Abe, I guess that's sort of, that they're sort of calling, really. We even see him in the flashback as well, sort of like I think like sh from the game Shadow, you see him as sort of a kid, like sort of alongside Maria, really, which is kind of. Who would expect that? I didn't,
I
really.
know, I know. But yeah, you're right, though. His name was, I'm just looking out, his name's Abraham Tower. But yeah, that's pretty cool. Like, I do like how, obviously, in Shadow the Hedgehog, if you guys played it, he had a proper strong hatred for Shadow because he thought he was responsible for Maria dying and everyone in the Ark. When really, it's crazy how Gunn were actually responsible for the murder of Maria and infiltrating the facility, yeah? And he actually becomes the Gun Commander, which is completely crazy. So, but I do like how, they reference that, and obviously, after Shadow the Hedgehog, he finds out what the real reason was, the truth and all, and obviously now he likes Shadow and they get on, and obviously eventually Shadow joins Gun, if you know, from Sonic 06. Oh God. But because I do know, if you complete Shadow the Hedgehog and you get A ranked in all the levels. I'm trying to do it right now on PC. It's so hard. But if you do it, you unlock something called expert mode. And basically, you have certain characters talking to Shadow at the start of each level. And you actually have one of the gun commander talking to Shadow and apologizing for all the hatred you had for him, even inviting him around for dinner as
Oh
well, which is pretty crazy
yeah,
to
I
hear.
think I vaguely remember that. Yeah, saw a video of that.
So it's like a, I know obviously Shadow the Hedgehog and Sonic 06 were not the best Sonic games, but I do like how there's a connection between the games of how Shadow becomes part of Gun. Like, Gun Commander and him basically just, become not friends, but they basically get over their beef and just work together, which is quite cool. But yeah, I did like that he was in it. That was a pretty cool thing. There are a lot of other like characters that appeared, but obviously they did reference also that Shadow beat the Black Arms. So like I said, the reference Shadow the Hedgehog. So yeah, but according for the game, like it'll be interesting to see what happens. Like I'm guessing it'll be Black Doom from the past, like from the Time Eater stuff, or it could be Black Doom survive. But I don't know how he would have survived because if you play Shadow the Hedgehog when he beat Devil Doom, the way he died there's no way he could have came back. I know anyone can come back. Look at Shadow in SA2, but I'm saying that death looked horrific. But
Yeah, I only saw recently, I think there was a question and answer from like the developers sort of about the new game. They're vague, it doesn't really reveal anything substantial, but I think they did comment answer your question sort of like oh, why is Black Doom back, sort of why did you choose him to sort of come back? And I think they did say they referenced this like, oh yeah, Sonic Generations has the Time Eater, it's about time travel, we'd use this opportunity just to bring back fan favorite characters, similar reason why we've seen characters like Neo Male Sonic or Male Overlord, Biolizard, and even recently Mephiles from the last trailer. They finally announced revealed he's going to be in the
Oh
game,
yeah, sorry, yeah, Mephiles,
which I've been, I don't know about you, I'm excited for, honestly. I think that's the I'm excited to see how he'll be played in, or at least his boss battle at least. So but no, I think they said that they don't exactly know why Black Doom is back, or if he's if it's a memory, or if it's something else entirely or something. But but they emphasizes, oh yeah, it's time travel, so it's
Oh yeah, so that makes
and the
sense.
trailer also did
Not the
reveal
Shadow
that
for
we'll
that
see
movie.
Maria again, which will be crazy, really, what they'll do with that. Not just flashbacks, just actually. Well, I don't know. It seems like it'll be a very interesting story, certainly. Far more interesting than the original Sonic Generations story. So but no, thinking back to the prologue or Dark Beginnings, like you said, it was just so great seeing Team Dark kind of reunited, like again Rouge and especially Omega. Like I think the short really reminded me how much I love Omega, just how much he's just so. It's just wants to just wreck shit, really. So.
And also just ruthless, isn't it? He doesn't give a shit about who you are. If you're part of Eggman's army or whatever, he'll just destroy you. Like when you have no, like, well, he's a robot, you have no compassion anyway. But yeah, he's just so ruthless and a badass, isn't it? And yeah, he has jokes as well, like when he's a robot, I call dibs, when
That's
it
such a
comes up.
perfect line for him, just to say. Oh, I don't know if they'll appear, how much they'll appear in the game, but I hope that they at least appear in some way
Yeah, I
or
doubt they'll
something.
be playable, but yeah, if they
No,
appear in it,
probably
that'd
not
be cool.
playable, but at
But
least there is a sort of as a reference or something,
they should bring back Team Dark, definitely. Obviously, Team Kingdom should bring back and Team Dark. They need to bring them back, man. Like Team Dark were really good. They just the characters, all three characters just work so well together as well. You know what I mean? So like Omega was abandoned by Eggman, has hatred towards him. Shadow, well, obviously, back then he didn't know much about his past. And, like, he had Rouge there with him as well, who was like government spy and all that. You're a government spy, Rouge the Bat. But yeah, he had all them. And also, what I did like was also we saw more about Shadow's relationship with Maria as well. We saw that a bit, and like then the Gun Commander referenced Maria briefly when talking to Rouge about she's probably the only one that Shadow might listen to. Well, that's what Rouge pointed out, I think, something like that.
Yeah, well, it's her,
But
but
yeah.
yeah, I mean, it is her, but bouncing to, well, no, the only one that Shadow would sort of, listen to be Maria. Well, she's long gone, so, leading to sort
Yeah,
of an
Eggman's cousin.
emotional bit, really. Again, it goes pretty hard on sort of like just the, like I can imagine for some, and not for me, well, but close, I won't lie, I did kind of feel moving at points, really, just sort of, just, just Shadow and Maria, sort of like, I think that it's there's a reason why I think, why Shadow is just so beloved, and why he's got a whole year to him, and they're doing all of this really, and he's going to be in the movie as well. I'm sure the movie will probably be very faithful from what little we've seen of it. Really, it seems like they're going to do that justice. But I think they've they just nailed that. Also, I have to say, the animation just incredible, really. Particularly, I think the action and the fighting and the choreography is just insane. I forget the name of the studio. I kind of feel bad that I've forgotten that, but they've done an amazing job, just capturing sort of the action. In some ways, it makes me wish the games could just take notes from that. Really, going all anime, just going all crazy, just sort of with all of that, really. Particularly the fight with Shadow, and shouldn't forget, I don't think it's Emerald, but definitely reference to Sonic Battle.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
You know, that was teased in the preview, like before the first one came out, but still, the fact they even referenced that, which,
we don't know if it's the same Emerald, is it? It could be a different, another version.
No, was it a Gizoid? I think they call the robot. So it's probably more likely that. Again, I've not played Sonic Battle, so I don't fully understand the context. But I think it is canon. It is true. And again, I just think it just goes to show how far they're going with this, really. Even like 5 years ago or something, we might not have gone something like that, really.
Well, no, it's cool. Yeah, I'm really looking forward to the game. Yeah, I'm definitely going to do a Let's Play of it as well, guys. So I'll probably do a Let's Play of Spark and Zero that came today. I'll probably play that. I will do some videos on that, but definitely do a Let's Play on Sonic Shadow Generations. Definitely, when that comes, I'm going to definitely be doing an LP on that. So be on the lookout for that. And I don't know what else I can say about this game. We've talked about this enough in other podcast episodes as well, but it's just going to be good. I hope it's going to be good. I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah, it's crazy. It's crazy. It's coming out pretty soon. Within like 2 weeks, really, or less than that, even.
And don't forget the movie as well in 2 months. That's going
to be
over 2 months. Yeah, that's going to be cool. Look forward to that as well. But yeah, it really has been a year of Shadow. But can't wait for that. Yeah. But what is anything else in mind, George, that you want to talk about? Anything in like in particular? Any topics?
We covered kind of like the main things. I guess sort of just a random thing. Maybe it's random for you, so at least I can't think of a time for that. But only I guess because it's on topic, or at least I think it's cool. Was the same. Was it the Sonic Central or something, a broadcast or so, where we got like the new Shadow trailer and they teased like the prologue animations. They usually showcase like products, and the past year or so, we've had the Lego Sonic sets out for like over a year now. They've been doing like sort of trailers or skits sort of for each of these presentations. There's always something just to obviously advertise the new Sonic sets. The trailer did was pretty funny. I thought it was really funny. It was just simply, essentially, it was a Zoom call between, was it Takashi Iizuka, like the producer of Sonic Team, just sort of trying to Lego Sonic, and he's still on a beach, and then he's calling on Shadow, and he's beating up the Bio Lizard, which we're getting a Lego Bio Lizard set. Like, I think that's insane.
Oh, nice.
It won't be until January, I think, but still, and it's getting Super Shadow and Super Sonic as figures in it as well. It's just like, can you? I wouldn't have believed you, 10 years ago or even 5 years ago or something, that you'd have said, "Oh, we get a not only Lego Sonic but like a Lego Bio Lizard set." And I think that's, I know it's to time with the movie and the game and everything, but still, I think that's really cool. It's not a. I don't think they revealed it in that presentation. It was leaked or something. But we're getting also a Lego set based on Tails' Cyclone, like his mech from SA2. And also comes with a male Sonic minifigure, which looks amazing. I'm definitely getting that set, certainly, because, I'll get whatever Lego Sonic I can, because if it isn't obvious, I'm a fan of Lego as well as Sonic. You probably may have known from history with the channel and whatever, but, No, the if you can look at, if you look up like the Lego Sonic video, it's pretty funny. I think they've you know, it lines up with a lot of like the recent social media stuff where they just like to reference gags and, you know, in jokes within the franchise or something. But I don't know, the videos that Lego and Sega are working with, you know, they're struck in gold, I'd say. You know, but
Yeah, they've done a lot of them recent Lego figures. Well, Sonic and well, Sega and Lego have had a lot of collaboration together, haven't they, recently? And wasn't there also a game briefly? Well, it wasn't just Sonic, but there was other Lego characters. What was the game?
Yeah,
Wasn't
oh
it
yeah,
something?
Lego Dimensions. Yeah, that
That's
was
it,
technically
yeah.
the first. That was the first actual Lego Sonic figure was from that. But yeah, he did. He was in the game. He crossovered with like Batman and like Gandalf and like Wildstar and like I think they had a cutscene of like they were flying through. I think Batman says, "I'm Batman," and Sonic's just staring like what? You know, it's just and also oh, and shouldn't forget the best cutscene, which was like you know, you see Shadow and Knuckles. That's like they're like in the void or something, and like Shadow has a gun out, is about to shoot like a badnik, and Knuckles like just throws the gun away as like you know. I think the
Oh yeah, I think
writers,
I remember that.
the
Yeah.
writers. I mean, TC Games. I think did they used, believe it or not, they did used to do what Sonic R and Sonic 3D Blast. So they've had history with Sonic before, but whoever the writers were clearly had fun, I think, with the with writing that story and everything. It was you know, it was still a Lego game at the end of the day, so you know, it was you know, wouldn't say it was like a an amazing game in itself. You know, if you enjoyed Lego games, it was fun, but I think like the writing was really good for that.
Yeah.
At least worth if you haven't go check out the cutscenes. Like for I'm sure there's like you know, people have made like a movie out of like the cutscenes from Lego Dimensions, you know, the Sonic story. I think it's literally called Sonic Dimensions, which I think was the name of a fake rumor from ages ago or something, which I don't know if that was if it's a wink and a nod to that, but if it was, that's amazing, you know. But but no, you're right. Yeah, that was that's. If not for that, we wouldn't have gotten the sets we got now. So you know, we're in quite the timeline now. It's quite a good time to be a Sonic fan, especially when you were younger. Like you know, sort of a younger fan now with you know, movie and Lego and you know, even Top Golf. I think that was also a funny announcement. Is that Top Golf doing like a collaboration with Sonic, which actually looks pretty cool, to be
Oh,
honest.
Topgolf.
Yeah, it's like those
What?
yeah, it's like those golf venues that have like screens. It's cool, you know. I've not been to it myself, but you know, I won't lie, at least it looks fun with the you know sort of with the with you know having the Sonic sort of like I know exactly what they're doing with it, but you know, it looks cool, you know. It just goes to show, you know, Sonic's just everywhere now, you know. I mean, he's always been a big name and something, but you know, now more than ever, really. It's you know.
Yeah, it's quite cool that. but yeah, I was thinking of talking about something else as well, but it's not Sonic related. But it's all right. We're open to talking about anything here. But Dragon Ball, you know, Sparking Zero. Yeah, got to talk about that game.
It did come out, so yeah.
yeah, it came out a couple of days ago. Well, it came out yesterday. But if you got the deluxe edition, it would have came out Monday, which is the 7th, I think. So yeah, if you wanted to pay 90 quid, then yeah, you could have got that. But I just paid the standard edition, which came today. I thought it would come yesterday, so I was a bit gutted it came now. But it's come now, it's installed. So when we're done here, I'm gonna be playing that all night. And but you know, if it goes well and the stuff I enjoy doing, I'll definitely do videos on it. So be on the lookout for that. But you know, it's obviously based off the Budokai Tenkaichi game, so I think the controls are similar. But I haven't played those games in so long, so I'm gonna have to get back into it again. I'll probably do like tutorials and all that and play that. But I've heard a lot of people say it's a really good game. A lot of people are really happy with it. I've got one of my friends who got the Doctor, and he said it's one of the best games he's played in years. And I was like, bloody hell. But, you know, I think it sold more than Black Ops 6, which is saying something as well, because it shows you how big Dragon Ball is.
Yeah,
And,
that's funny, sort of hearing it that.
I know. And it's only like, what, 30 gig compared to like place. Because Black Ops 6 is like 300 gig or something, like the download, it's ridiculous, something like that. It's really crazy, 150 gig, something like that. But yeah, I'm gonna play that. I mean, I know people said that the game can be quite challenging in some aspects. Like I think, like what I've seen, you could do a normal story mode branch, but then obviously if you change the, if you do something else, like a what if, then it will create another branch for what if branch. But on that what if branch, the diff you don't can't set the difficulty. Difficulty is always set to hard, and the characters are like crazy. Like, I saw a video of Raditz. Goku fighting Raditz. Raditz is dodging like Muhammad Ali, man. It was crazy. You know, like if Raditz is doing that, imagine when he faces the bigger characters like Frieza, Cell, Boo, Beerus, you know? God. So, yeah, I might try to What If branch on it, but I'm looking forward to it. You know, I'm going to be rubbing. I heard that Great 8 Vegeta is really hard, so I'm not looking forward to that. I've seen videos of people just tweaking out, raging at it, saying, what's going on? I've seen it just spam the same move over and over again.
Yeah, I didn't look too deep, but I did see something. I think you would reach. I saw a clip of like someone was like constantly retrying, and I think he did like a special move upon like retrying. It seemed unfair, I'll be honest. I'm hoping if that's exactly what's, if that's a common thing, then yeah, hopefully they're gonna patch it or something, because it does seem a bit, you know, a little too much, you know, sort of for that. But you know, hopefully at least the game itself, you know, the core game at least it's fun. You know, again, I will be honest, I'm not as huge a Dragon Ball guy as you are, but you know, but as an outsider, you know, even like me, you know, some attachment, like mostly I've seen some of the recent films, and definitely know the Abridged series. That's kind of our connection, really, is through that. But you know, as an outsider still, it looks amazing. Like, it looks insane. Like, visuals and just sort of how far they've gone with the spectacle of it, really. It definitely looks like it might be the Dragon Ball game, you know. And mind you, you know, you Dragon Ball fans, you've been eating well, really, because you've had, Kakarot and Fighters and, like, numerous sort of stuff, really, which it seems to be good quality. But, you know, I know you've been excited for this one, and, you know, a lot of Dragon Ball fans are excited, hence the sales and sort of everything.
So I grew up with the Tenkaichi games, isn't it? So, yeah, that's why it's special to me, this game. But, you know, couldn't have it all if it weren't for Toriyama, you know. Again, like, you know, may he rest in peace.
Yeah, it's unfortunate. It's really,
yeah.
I mean, also, I think that new show also just came out, was about to come out, Daima. That's also...
Yeah, it came out yesterday, yeah. I haven't seen it yet. I need to find out how I can watch it. So, you know, I'll watch it legally. Yeah, definitely, definitely. No, what I mean is, I've got to figure out how to watch it.
Because think, I found out Netflix are airing it, apparently. You know,
I don't know if that's an American one or...
I think,
no, well.
I think it's
know.
The UK one. I mean, you know, don't take my word for it, but still. You know, but I know it's in the, you know, it'll be released somehow. So, be interesting how that will go.
I'm looking forward to it. Yeah, I'll definitely check it out. And, yeah, I've heard some reviews. People said it was quite good and all that animation. But, yeah, I haven't seen much because I don't want to get spoiled too much on it. But yeah, I'll definitely give that a go. But yeah, you know, I'm gonna probably be playing Sparking Zero all night, guys. No sleep. Nah, I'm joking. Not that bad. But yeah, I could be you on that proper. Like, I'm looking forward to it. Yeah, I've apparently got much else to talk about. I'm happy to cut it short now, George, unless you're happy to add anything.
No, I think I'm good. No, I think we've talked enough.
Not rushing because of Sparking Zero, but I'm just saying, like, you know, I think we talked about quite a lot, covered quite a lot of what we want to talk about.
I mean, a little under 40 minutes. I think that's pretty good. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, it might be a bit over if I'm able to show the Sonic Symphony footage that I recorded. So, guys, if I have managed to successfully import it from my phone onto here, then obviously be sure to check out the end of this video. But, yeah. Anyway, George, it's been a pleasure as always, and so looking forward to episode 4, so which we'll do in, I think we'll most likely do it after the game, Sonic Extra Generations come out, so we'll talk more about that, I think.
Yeah, but, I think that's a good plan, yeah.
Yeah, so yeah, guys, hope you enjoyed this podcast, and like I said, be sure to check out Sonic Symphony footage if it's at the end of the video. And yeah, catch you guys in 2 weeks. And also, like I said before, if you did also come to the same Sonic Symphony event, let me know in the comments below. Or even if you didn't go to this one, if you're from America, went to the America one, or even the one that George went to a year ago, let us know in the comments below. We'd be interested to hear your experiences, and you'd share your experiences with us. Like, we'll be interested to know. So do let us know. But yeah, I'll see you guys later. Take care and bye.
Yeah, thanks for listening. Cheers. Bye. Oh,
And then I started to